Do you remember what Roxanne said in regards to the German soldier? He kept saying something to her about a specific object.
It's like a nut or bolt thing.
Maybe it was less about messing with me and more about guiding me to that.
Makes sense.
Seems very likely this German soldier is the presence that Caitlin is terrified of and the same entity that touched her.
Things are definitely just bouncing around down here.
I feel like we need to maybe dig a layer deeper about the history of this building itself. It's an old town, it's an old building. I'm sure somebody, you know, knows something more than what we've been able to gather at this point.
Corey, who is a volunteer at the community center where cheerleading coach Caitlin feels she's being stalked, has done some research on the building. He has agreed to meet with us.
I was hoping you could tell us a little bit about some of the research you've done on this location.
The building was built in 1911. It was built for families, something for them to do. They had billiard parlors, basketball, gymnastics, and stuff like that. A couple years after it was opened, there was a horrible disaster. The Dawn disaster. June 29th, 1941, right as World War II was kicking off, 35 people from here in town headed out to Mohegan Island just for a picnic for the day. On the return ride back on the ferry, it exploded. They don't know what caused it. A lot of people say it was a U-boat possibly, because there is a German U-boat that is sunk off the coast of Maine. Out of the 35 people that perished that day, they were only able to recover 14 of the bodies. Since they were all from this area, they actually brought the bodies back here, right above where we're at right now in the gym area, and they had a giant wake, if you will. Does that have any bearing on what's going on here? I honestly don't know, but just peculiar.
Notable.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of history here at the community center. The little boy could very well have been a victim of the Dawn disaster. And the German soldier could have been on a U-boat that destroyed the Dawn. Whatever these entities may be, Caitlin must confront them in order to overcome her fear.
We were able to conduct our own investigation. During that time, we were able to replicate a lot of what you shared with us. We had instances with the basketballs.
Oh, yeah.
And we felt the presence of the small boy that you spoke about. Down in the basement where you felt uneasy, where things were more physical, we had an experience with what we believe was the same entity that touched you.
Wow. Caitlin, what's haunting the rec center, we believe, are the victims of a horrible boating disaster where 35 people died, men, women, and children from this community, and possibly a German soldier from a U-boat that may have caused the disaster.
The bodies they recovered were brought back here to the rec center. They used this space as a morgue.
We want to help you to not be scared to be here and do your job, to not be scared to be in the basement. And the best way to do that is to have you face whatever's there one-on-one, alone.
We're going to use your fear to draw it out.
What we would like to do is actually take away your sense of sight so that you're able to feel more than see whatever may be there or whatever may happen while you're in the room. Are you okay with that?
Pretty nervous to be down there by myself, but.
We're gonna ask you to wear this on your head while you're down there.
Oh my God.
And with your permission, I'd like to put this on you.
Sure.
Can you put your arms out in front of you and I'll help guide you?
I'm scared.
And I'm right behind you, okay?
Okay, just walk forward with me. There you go.
All right, and there's the step.
Step down. There you go. Okay, second to the last. That's the last before you step to the bottom. There you go.
Oh my God, we're in the basement. I hate it down here.
Breathe for me. Very good. And go ahead and set.
Okay, we've placed surveillance cameras in here so that we can see you. We also put a walkie next to you so that we'll be able to speak with you and walk you through the process. And we will be able to hear you as well, so you can speak to us. We've placed two EMF meters on either side of you. And when they have a reading that tells us that there's something here with you, you'll hear a beep. If you hear something in the room, if you're feeling like you're being touched, anything you feel, mm-hmm. let us know. And the last thing that's important for you to know is nobody will be down here with you.
Okay.
Just give us a few moments to get to our monitor.
Okay.
All right.
You doing okay down there, Caitlin?
I'm a little shaky. I wonder when I can leave.
She's so scared right now.
I'm very nervous. I don't like it.
I understand that you're scared, and it's a lot to ask for you to be down there by yourself. Just remember to keep breathing. If at any point in time, Caitlin, while you're down there, if you do feel as though there's something in the room, just make sure you share that with us.
Okay. If you're the German soldier, why are you here? There's a knock to my left side.
I heard that. And no one's down there.
Two knocks.
Yeah, we heard that as well. Very distinct.
That was to my right. It feels like the same presence that touched me.
That meter would tell us that something got very, very close to you.
And there's a beep again to my right side. Mm-hmm. I don't like it. It's getting too much. It's very loud, and it's like it's very close to me. I don't like it.
Oh, my God.
That's interesting.
What just happened?
Oh. There it is again.
What is this?
Streak there. There's something like that.
I feel like the soldier is screwing with his camera.
Oh, my God.
Something just touched my lower back, I think.
That just cut out totally. Something's down there with her.
I don't like it.
What is happening?
Wait. The TV's on in the basement.
No.
What the hell? You have to turn the switch to turn
it on. That's one of those old school knobs. So we have interference here. We have the TV going on.
Now the soldier's absolutely screwing with the energy, mm-hmm. with her energy, with this camera, with the TV. The one camera in the main part of the basement is still randomly sort of having interference turning on and off.
It's getting too much.
I know it's hard to confront whatever's there.
Are you willing to lay out the ground rules, find as much bravery as you can and verbalize that?
This is something she needs to do.
Who is here? I would like to keep all interactions positive and would like to keep as much away from the children as possible.
So that they aren't afraid to come here and we won't be afraid to come down in the basement and get what we need to when we have to, because this is our space as well.
Oh, she did it. She did it. She did it.
She took off the hood.
Yeah. Well, that was a big step. How does it feel?
Even though it's very scary, I feel proud of myself for being here and getting this far.
How are you doing?
Hi, Caitlin.
Good.
You know, I know it can be really scary to go somewhere, especially the place you're afraid of the most.
Yeah.
But you did it, and we got to watch that all unfold, so we're very, very impressed.